I work for a wonderful man, the late Stan Korsmeyer. He was one of the first people to identify and characterize this protein called BCL2 that turns out to be really important in keeping cancer cells alive. First step we wanted to find out, because no one had ever found this out, is can we test in a way that if we get rid of BCL2 in an actual leukemia, will the leukemia go away? Think about Dana-Farber, I could just go right down the hall and say, John, can you give me some chronic lymphocytic leukemia? And I just simply took those cells and exposed them to this drug, and it killed the cells. And that meant this was something that we could start to apply to people. And that became the drug known as venetoclax.
I met with Dr. Latai, and I started to develop a leukemia portfolio, essentially studying how these drugs work in patients with leukemia.
Dr. Garcia, she was fabulous. She's just been incredibly supportive, cheerful.
He was diagnosed at 2 months with ALL-MLL rearrange. They told me that he wasn't going to make it past 6 months.
One of the special things about Dana-Farber is people here really care, and we happen to have the tools to try to make it better. And turns out targeting these proteins are incredibly important in chronic leukemias and acute myeloid leukemias as well. What's really great about a lot of these inhibitors is that many of them are oral and many of them are incredibly well tolerated.
My understanding is that because I did so well at my age, 80, that they have changed their criteria. We're taking people into clinical trials.
We now are able to offer our older patients or more frail patients an active and safe treatment.
The venetoclax combinations are specially designed so that they can be given to this older population. And that's really important because they're most of the people who get AML.
My grandfather lived to 90, so that's the next shot. So I'm gonna get there.
He's in remission for over a year now. Thanks to Dana-Farber.
It's been a really great experience for me to be with the patients and offer them clinical trials that I got to develop here.
Now it's worldwide. There's FDA approvals, but also all the regulatory agencies around the world have approved this drug for the use in chronic lymphocytic leukemia. But I had the privilege of seeing it happen for the first time right here.
I really look forward to seeing how our local discoveries can lead to new discoveries elsewhere. And I think that's a really wonderful thing.
To be able to have the purpose of trying to find better treatments for cancer patients, to see that succeed, well, I mean, that's about all I would want out of my job for my life.